a decent match. There was only ever going to be one winner after he raced into an early lead. Assistance of Pisan Franity. Did show plenty of it in this second game. Lee Chong Wei just had too much for him. And a popular victor, Lee Chong Wei, into the final. So this is how it stood so far. As you can see, Lee Chong Wei into the final. First match was off stake. The other men's singles affair, which saw Hans Christian Vidinghus win as well. Kuriara Shinoi, very impressive. And Huang's equally so in the mixed doubles, which leaves just the men's doubles affair. Another chance to see Indian action. No win so far for the Indians out on court, but here's their opponents. Takeshi, Kamura, and Keigo Sonoda.
And from India, Manu, Attri, Sumeeth, Reddy.
And there is Manu Attri and B. Sumeeth Reddy. Winner of this match will take on Liu Yuchen, Li Junhui, or another Japanese pair in Takuru Hoki, Yugo Kobayashi, who yet to get out on court. Pairs very close on the world rankings, never met before. So, tough one to call, really.
Green is the call. Choice.
Attri and Sumeeth Reddy are certainly, maybe form wise, been a little better. They've certainly this year had more success, one at the end of last year, one at the start of this year. And as you can see in the quarterfinals, Attri and Reddy coming through against the English pair of Ellis and Langridge, whereas Kamura and Sonoda came up against the Lees of Chinese Taipei, taken to three games as well, they were. Let's have a look at the Indian pair first. Manu Attri and Sumeeth Reddy. Reddy, 23 years of age, Attri 22. And 26, their highest ranking that they've been. Beat China's top pair at the All England this year. They knocked out the number two seeds. As you can see on Thursday, Hashimoto and Hirata in the game that lasted just over an hour. World ranked number 15 pair, who they also beat at last year's World Championship. So they, a pair that certainly have shown what they're capable of. It's Sonoda at the far end. Both 25 years of age. Lost the second game yesterday, but 21-18 in the third. Straight games elsewhere. Winners of the German Open last year. Reached the last 16 of the World Championships. They actually won this tournament, the US Open Grand Prix Gold, back in 2013. So looking to win this for the second time. So the last of the five semi-finals on court one.
Ladies and gentlemen, on my right, Takeshi, Kamura, Keigo, Sonoda, Japan. And on my left, Manu, Attri, Sumeeth, Reddy, India. Sumeeth, Reddy to serve to Takeshi, Kamura, love all, play.
So, men's doubles semi-finals, they often can be the most entertaining of the lot. And Indian pair of Manu Attri and B. Sumeeth Reddy. Showing that they have the capability of beating some of the top pairs around the world. When they beat Chai Bao and Hong Wei at the All England, they were the highest ranked Chinese pair at the time. But Takeshi Kamura and Keigo Sonoda obviously winning this tournament, won the German Open last year. Certainly settled the quicker of the two.
2.
And now, please warmly welcome the semi-finalists of the men's doubles. From China, Li Junhui, Liu Yuchen.
Should be Sumeeth Reddy. I mentioned their win over the Chinese belt, the All England. To be fair, they haven't actually won a match since the All England until they came here this week. But obviously, confidence looks pretty high, doesn't it? They don't look like a pair that have struggled to win matches.
Service over 7-3.
Japanese pair lost in the first round of the last two Super Series events in Australia and Indonesia. They made it to the quarterfinals, not just at the All England, but the Asian Badminton Championships as well. That's going to be easily put away by Sumeeth Reddy. It's hard always to say that a pattern's established this early on in a match, but I have to say it's been just the sort of start the Indian pair would have wanted. That's a poor miss by Manu. Should have been 10-4. Stages, Manu Attri and B. Sumeeth Reddy have been sprightly, sharp and incisive, and they have an 11-5 lead at the interval in this men's double semi-final. They've seen to the number two seeds. Why shouldn't they see to the number four seeds as well? The pair, of course, from Japan too, in Hashimoto and Hirata. They could know all about their strengths and weaknesses, of course, from their compatriots. But there's no stopping them at the moment. They just look the livelier of the two, don't they? I mean, you don't win 13 in the first 18 points for nothing, but You know what I mean? There's a greater spring in the step, isn't there? Actually, they're particularly bouncing around, isn't it? More live wire. Your rackets.
Hold. 13.
More like it from the Japanese pair, 3 points in a row. Fair to say that 25% of the crowd have made their way out after seeing the star attraction of Lee Chong Wei, but been a pretty good men's doubles affair so far. Easy pickings for Sumeeth Reddy there.
Service over 14-8.
Tightened up a little bit now, haven't it? Yeah, very much so.
11-14.
Six of the last 7 points Kamura and Sonoda have won. Established again a big lead. Nicely placed, wasn't it?
12-16.
Plenty of guile about that shot from Sonoda there. That was a shame.
Service
couldn't quite repeat the trick. Just
12.
Too long.
Do not influence the line judge. Do not influence the line judge.
You hear that? The umpire just tell him not to influence the line judge by calling the shot out before it's actually given out. Rally of the day, that one. Maybe drew a bit of Indian joy after
service over 18.
Defeats on this
13.
Court just now for Isai Pranit against Lee Chong Wei, and of course for Joanna Grudeau and Ashwini Ponapa. A little bit early on in their women's doubles match against the Japanese pair of Kurihara and Shinoya. Or so to suggest that this is another match that could go the distance. Even if the Indian pair do take this opening game, which is not quite yet a formality.
15, 18.
Given long.
Too
convinced himself, but. Well, the lead down to two. Remember, it was 13-5 at one stage. He said mine. Indeed, it was his. Game points.
20.17.
There you go, opening game goes the way of the Indian pair of Manu Attri, B. Sumeeth Reddy.
First game won by
21
Manu
points
Attri.
To 17.
Sumeeth Reddy, 21.
Yeah, you get the feeling that it could be a way back into this for the Japanese pair, but well played. by the Indian two there. Off to a flyer and work to be called in that opening set. Some of the highlights from that opening game. For the second game here. Can the Indian pair get it polished and done with for the day right now? Or are they going to be forced into a third by Kamura and Sonoda, who take the opening point? It dangled on the top of the net.
4-2.
So Kamura's way. Guided by the Indian player there. Sumeeth Reddy, a flick of a backhand. More of a smash this time.
5-4.
Not getting over that tall figure, was it? the frame of the racket.
Service over, 5-all.
You know, this match takes on the winner on the other court with Li Junhui, Liu Yuchen, just taking the first set against the Japanese pair of Hoki and Kobayashi.
Service over.
And as it stands,
six, five.
Two Japanese mixed doubles pairs in the semi-final, both could be heading out. For the Japanese six. Players. Opened up a little bit of a lead now. You can see that one drop wide of the mark. Different affair now, isn't it? Sonoda and Kamura have been gonna set down. They've taken the advantage here in the second, 11 points to 6. To a third set in this men's double semi-final. We'll see.
Service over 7-11.
Start here, the Indian pair.
over 12-9. Service over 10-12.
Much in the way of rallies right now, but for the Indian pair, they've closed the gap since the interval.
Service over 13-11.
Ripping through to get that point, covering the court well. Sonoda and Kamura here. And now they trout in this 14, second game 13. As well. And the Indian pair looking to make their first final since January. That's wide.
Service over 14 all.
Towards the finishing line, aren't they? Out, and you can see for Sonoda and Kamura now things are getting desperate. Well left by Manu Attri, 3 points the gap, 3 points from victory. Snaps to that one, did Manu Attri.
16-18.
Look of anguish from Kamura. Not just slipping away now. Had a nice lead at the interval. But all credit to the Indian pair, Manu Attri and Sumeeth Reddy hit. their toes right from the start, and now they have match points.
20, match point 16.
Well, they look as if they're going to knock out another Japanese pair here. One match point save.
Service order, 17-20.
He's left it, and they've done it. Into a final at Grand Prix gold level for the first time. Manu Attri and B. Sumeeth, they'd already knocked out the number two seeds. They've now beaten the number four seeds as well. It's a wonderful win and a comprehensive one as well. 21-17, they took the second set over Takeshi Kamura and Keigo Sonoda there. And look at the joy it brings. Don't know yet who they'll be playing, but their job is done in just over half an hour. 21-17 in the first and second games for the Indian duo. They'll either take on Liu Yuchen and Li Junhui, who took the first set against the other Japanese pair in the semis, Tohukuru Hoki and Yugo Kobayashi. But for Manu Attri and Sumeeth Reddy, I don't think they care who they play in the final. They are there with a chance to win the US Open tomorrow. Got off to such a positive start, and that was the way they won it in the end. Pure joy as well. Great to see. Pair on their way up, it would seem. Lovely celebrations. So let's look back at what we had on offer here on Court 1, semi-finals of the Yonex Suffolk Community College US Open. Hans Christian Vittinghus at the start of the day, turning it around to be the number one seed. Jia Tianchen, he'll play Li Chongwei in tomorrow's final after the former world number one saw B-side Planet in what was a pretty comprehensive display from the Malaysian. Kurihara and Shinoya, well, they dismantled Gudu and Ponapa without too many problems at all. Michael Fuchs and Bigot Melkos fought hard, didn't they, against the Chinese youngsters Huang Kaixiang, Huang Dongping. But they looked a fine pairing, didn't they, the Chinese? And then just to end it there, some joy at last for the Indians out on this court with Manu Attri and B. Sumeeth Reddy coming through in straight games against the Japanese pair of Kamura and Sonoda. So looking back at that last men's doubles match, a match that started with the Indian pair on the front foot, and that's the way it remained. There was some brief resistance, wasn't there, in that second game from Kamura and Sonoda. When they took the interval lead, you thought, well, maybe this could go to a third game. But that's not the way it proved to be. Brief resistance, as it turned out. The victory moment. Oh, it tastes good, doesn't it? Maybe the celebration needs a little bit of work, but maybe they might get another chance tomorrow. Well, some terrific finals to look forward to tomorrow. Hopefully you can join us from Long Island in New York. Lots of great action to come. But from now, for myself, Richard Kaufman, it's goodbye.